First question is, and this exhibition theme is a transformation. And for you, Sana, what means transformation is for you? And also, how your work in the exhibition related to transformation?
With the historical wounds, the works of 1980, essentially the works of art in that performance, to say the copies, the small important paintings, they transformed me. They transformed my life. They transformed my heart. They gave me wounds, in a sense. So the performance is about this, that I take these masterpieces and I'm also transforming them in a kind of new world, in my world, in my universe. That's the reason the series calls Historical Wounds. Because for me, beauty has to do with the wounds. Real beauty hurts me. It leaves a wound behind. And these wounds, they transform me. Then the chapitre, the hoofdstukken, the 18 heads, heads in bronze and in wax, for me, that is a kind of on different level, you know, it's a tradition of the self-portrait. The self-portrait out of the fascination for the other. The self-portrait for me, the study of the physiognomy as a landscape. It's also transformation is for me something almost daily. These portraits also talk about, let us say, the longing, the desire to gain the wisdom, the knowledge, the power of animals. I mean, for me, this every animal has in my life a reason. For example, the donkey ears. I remember I had a stand in school when I was not listening. I had to wear donkey ears to stand in the corner in the lower school. It was always kind of punishment because this donkey was stupid. He was, and of course, a donkey is not stupid. It's a very intelligent animal. So it's also a transformation you go through as a young boy, standing in the corner, being punished. It's a very, I remember it as a very physical and a mental transformation and humiliation almost. Through the humiliation, the transformation came because he had to stand there for hours in the corner with your head like this. So essentially every animal, it's also like the ones with the horns. I see this like almost like a growing out of my skull, out of the bone. And you know, I made all the works with also human bones and animal bones. It's like almost like a crown. An antenna. It's something almost also a kind of sexual transformation. It's like almost like the proudness and the virility of man. So in a sense, this all these heads, they are a kind of almost also a masks of longing. In which state you would like to be, or in which state you were once. So. Mm-hmm. And for me, they also in a sense, they're a kind of almost like moral place. Mm-hmm. Moral place. They're almost. I'm going from 20 to 70 in these ads, and they're for me also a kind of almost Catholic Christian moral place, a kind of Zinne puppets, Zinne heads. You could say the reason 18 steps or the 18 steps all almost like the Garden of Delight from Jeroenisch Bosch, the relation between animal, nature. It's almost a sexual encounter with this.
Okay. Thank you very much. And also, anyway, so we just make it very short. The second question is, if you have a second life after this life, and what you want to be? You want to be transformed to animals and butterflies, or yourself?
I would wish to come back as myself, yes, and you know, I believe it takes a lifetime to become a young artist, and when there would be a reincarnation, I would like to not be so old when I was young. I would like to become quicker young. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. The last question is, and now it's we are kind of very quite difficult and a transitional time to politically, economically, also socially, everything has been changing a lot. So, with under this uneasy circumstances, and this exhibition was organized as a transformation. It's like a new kind of idea, a proposal, what you want to be, but a time of transformation. So under this kind of situation, or you see in this exhibition, and is there any kind of message to the audiences and to come to this exhibition?
Yeah, I think the for me, that's also the heads for me. The heads are based on almost old bustes from history, huh? And for me, they're also kind of, these heads are kind of animal warriors. They are proud, in a sense. For me, the pieces also talk about a kind of belief in humankind, belief in beauty, almost a kind of homage to the intelligence of animals, because animals are still the best doctors and philosophers in this world. So, for that reason, I believe in art. I believe in beauty. Mm-hmm. Beauty has an incredible force. Mm-hmm. I think even when so many things economically, politically, socially, or so-called transforming, I think what always is winning for me is the force of beauty in art.